in this workshop on different aspects of highway engineering to be presented by eminent professors and speakers from IIT Kharagpur. We are privileged to host you, sirs. For the inaugural program, I would like to call upon on the stage the dignitaries. First, our Chief Engineer Headquarter, Sri Amitabh Sengupta, please come out to the stage, sir. Next, Sri Uttam Kanjilal, Chief Engineer Headquarter, PWD Roads, please come out to the stage, sir. Sri Devashish Ghosh, Chief Engineer, National Highway, please come onto the street, sir. Sri Sri Kumar Bhattacharya, Engineer in Chief and Ex-Officio Secretary, PWD, please. Then our Additional Chief Secretary, sir, PWD Government of West Bengal, Sri Indibar Pandey, sir. Next, I would like to call upon eminent professors from IIT. Professor B.B. Pandey, sir, please. Professor K.S. Reddy, sir, please. Professor M.A. Amarnath, sir, please. In this inaugural program, we will welcome the dignitaries on the dais with a bouquet of flowers. For that, I would request our lady assistant engineers to present the bouquet of flowers to the eminent professors. First, to Professor B.V. Pandey. Next, Professor K.S. Reddy, sir. Next, Professor M. Amarnath Reddy, sir. Next, Professor Kranti Kumar Kona, sir. We'd also welcome the dignitaries on the dais of our offices. First, Additional Chief Secretary, Sri Indipa Pandey, sir. We'd welcome our ENC, sir, Sri Kumar Bhattacharya. We'd welcome Sri Uttam Kanjilal, sir, Chief Engineer Headquarters, PW Roads. We'd welcome Sri Amitabh Sengupta, Chief Engineer Headquarters, PWD. We'd welcome Sri Devashish Ghosh, Chief Engineer, National Highway.
Interact correctly and to the point, and with these my words, I welcome you all and thank you also for today's gathering. Okay, thank you.
Now I would request our Additional Chief Secretary, PWD Government of West Bengal, Sri Indibar Sen, to deliver the keynote address.
Professor B.B. Pandey, Professor K.S. Reddy, Professor M.A. Reddy, Professor K.K. Kuna, INC, and dear colleagues. PWD West Bengal is the main department for maintenance and upgradation of the roads, a portion of NHS, all the state highways, all other major and other district roads. As of now, we are maintaining around 19,000 kilometers of road, out of which almost 1,700 kilometers is NH, 3,600 kilometers is state highway, another 12,000 kilometers is ODRs, and lately, in the last 6 months or so, we have taken a large number of roads from Jilla Parishad and municipalities, which comes to around 3,000 kilometers. We are again in process of taking over more and more roads from Jilla Parishads and municipal bodies, mainly because they don't have the capacity to upgrade these roads to appropriate standards, both financially and technically. So a in principle decision has been taken that all the important roads which are being maintained by these local bodies would be gradually transferred to PWD. PWD over the last 6 years or so has seen massive changes, which we did not envisage probably when we joined the service or till quite late in the service. In 2010-11, our plan budget used to be of the size of around 700 crores, out of which probably we are spending only 500 crores on roads. If you add NS, it will be another 100 crores. So in 2010-11, we are spending around 600 crores on road sector in total. Today, if you see, we expect this year to spend almost 4,000 crores on state roads and at least 1,200 crores on national highway. So from a level of 600 crores, we have reached to almost 5,300 crores. And let me tell all of you, we have no dearth of fund as far as road sector goes. We started, our officers, engineers started from the stage where probably most of them had never worked in a project in the real sense. Many of the chief engineers probably have reached at that stage only doing surfacing works. And if they were very lucky, they ended up getting some ADB or World Bank project where they got real exposure to quality road construction. But rarely you will find a road in West Bengal, I mean the old roads, which have not been done by ADB or World Bank or those kind of grants and which are in a good condition. I mean those were the only roads which were properly designed and properly constructed. The officers who had exposure to those roads are actually the people who have been able to give suggestions and make appropriate changes in the system we work in. Now, coming from that situation, when we suddenly come that we are spending almost what we are spending 5 years back on the entire state, there are districts in the state where we are spending 600 crores in a year. So to that extent, probably what the chief engineer was doing at that time, many of the executive engineers are executing to the tune of that particular amount. But we have realized that for this kind of work, the kind of exposure, kind of training which we required in pavement design, pavement construction, somehow are lacking quite a lot. Over the last 1.5 to 2 years, we have been sending our officers to Indian Academy of Highway Engineers in Noida. And they have got a lot of exposure to different things. But considering the size of the department and the level of work, it has not been possible to send every possible engineer to these institutions. We considered that in such a situation, best option would be to have one-day workshop and maybe later on more frequent workshops with the premier institutes of the country. We are lucky to have IIT Kharagpur, who are close by, and the Professor Pandey and his team, they have kindly agreed to our request to hold a one-day workshop. We are really grateful to the team from IIT Kharagpur. The state, if you see, for the benefit of all of us, our state is a unique state in the country. Only state where you have hills in the north to the extent that many of these places are inaccessible in winter. You have beach on the other side in Digha. You have soil conditions which vary from laterite in some areas with very high CVR value to black cotton soil or very soil which is very heavy, which has a very heavy percentage of clay. So you have virtually all kinds of conditions varying from Darjeeling to Digha and from Bankura to Sundarbans. Construction of roads in such situations is quite challenging, and every particular road requires a different treatment. Unlike, say, most of the states in Gangetic Plateau or in Deccan Plateau, where you will have fairly uniform kind of geography and the soil conditions, which makes to that extent road construction much more easier. For us also, if you see, for a long time, there was hardly any investment in the road sector, and due to which the traffic density in most of our roads has gone beyond the capacity of the roads. On top of that, there are several problems which we face compared to other states. One, till some time ago, was rampant overloading. We have problems of land. Land acquisition is becoming progressively more difficult because of very high population density. We have riven development all along the urban areas. I mean, outside Calcutta, if you see, entire urban development in that sense takes place along the roadside. And there is a lot of encroachment in such situations. Now, when we are upgrading these roads, mainly by widening and strengthening, you have all possible challenges which you can face, at least in Bengal. Probably if you can make a quality road in Bengal, you can make it anywhere else in the country. I'm quite convinced of that. And that's what we see also, in fact. Lately, we are having some more issues which are environmental concern about too much of waste material being generated by, rebuilding the roads. When we excavate the roads, we take out the scarify, the bituminous surfaces, and these are left on the side. Then over a period of time, when you keep working on the same road, at least in urban areas, you keep raising the level of the roads, which is creating a problem for the people who are staying on either side. Their access is getting difficult to the main road progressively. Normally in such situations, we should have service road, but there are very few roads in the state where you have service roads. With such a huge quantum of work going, you need huge quantum of natural resources, granular material, sand, which is becoming problematic getting these in time, mainly because of courts and the different environmental issues which are being posed. What we need in such situation is probably a design of road which maximizes the available material on site, which can be constructed in probably the fastest possible time, keeping in view huge traffic load on over this thing, and also which can last, because most of our roads don't have good drainage. Last 2-3 years, we have experimented with various combinations. We have used concrete pavement in a big way. We have used concrete block pavement. Normally, DBMBC, we have been using quite intensively in most of the important roads. We have also used improving the subgrade subbase by different treatment, which Professor Pandey is aware. We wanted that all our officers who are undertaking a lot of these projects should get a exposure to the latest techniques in the road construction, both pavement design and pavement construction. We found there's nobody better than IIT Kharagpur in this regard. And it's this background that we had requested IIT Kharagpur to come and hold a one-day workshop. I'm really grateful to the professors from IIT Kharagpur that they have been able to spare one day of their valuable time and come and enlighten us on the latest techniques in road construction, latest technologies, and what will be best suited for us depending on the terrain, geography, and soil conditions. We welcome the team from IIT Kharagpur. Thank you.
We didn't get many slips. I think about 6 or 7 are there. Considering stress construction, 15 years design period for granular layer and 5 years for bituminous layer. And when designing with the help of IIT PAVE, how both the MSS are considered for permissible strains. I think this is related to stress designing. The guidelines suggest that you do the bituminous mix for 5 years and then the granular layer will have to come for the full design period. I think the guidelines are not very clear in terms of how exactly it should be done. Your normal limiting strain, which is for a full depth pavement. So it is not quite proper. I think in one of the consultancy projects we addressed this. So we have done the analysis slightly differently. You have to do it slightly differently, right? So some modification is required. So it is not fair to consider that the granular layer, the number that it gives, will be okay for a 15-year period because you are only putting as a part of the asphalt layer. It is not covered by the full asphalt layer. So you cannot use the analysis as it is. Right? So I can actually pass on the details of how we did in that consultation. That was for a Rajasthan energy project. Same stress construction. Those layers were extending full width. If they were not extending full width, that is no more a drainage layer. So if it was not extending full width, if you can make an arrangement for extending that to full width, take it as a drainage layer, use it as a drainage layer, GSP, unless it has fully contaminated by subgrade material, clay material, getting deposited in the layer. If that is the case, you'll have to remove it, and then use the fresh aggregates, otherwise considered to be subgrade. The IRC has given some guidelines as to what are the situations for which you can select PMB, CRMA and so on. Unless you are referring to specific issues related to their durability and constructability, some binders are not so workable, other binders are more workable. PMB and CRMA, you have to go for higher temperatures. If you have an issue with your mixing plants, heating the binders to those temperatures, then you might as well go for your VZ grades, maybe stiffer grades. Otherwise, I think when to select PMB, when to select CRMB, it is in terms of the maximum temperature, also in terms of the traffic that you carry on your roads. Okay, what is fixed traffic, fixed vehicle, and what is the correlation between them in the design? I explained this in the morning, but I'll quickly explain that. Fixed vehicle is what we generally do in IRC 37. We are considering a fixed vehicle which is a standard, not a vehicle, but standard axle. It equivalent to standard axle. All the traffic that we project over the next 15 years, whatever number, all of them will have to be converted into equivalent repetitions of that load unit. How to do that? That fourth power rule or equivalence factors that are available, use them and convert all the numbers of vehicles into equivalent repetitions of the standard load. So it is not a fixed vehicle, but that is a fixed vehicle approach. But fixed traffic, as I said, in the case of airports, previously that is what we used to do. We used to identify the heaviest aircraft that would use the airport, designed for 10,000 repetitions. The 10,000 repetitions is my fixed traffic, but that is okay when I am selecting the heaviest one. Next heavier one is so small compared to the biggest one. Others are insignificant. So that is what my fixed vehicle, fixed traffic design approach is.
Include engine portability. There are some limitations in the BBD, like in case of cracked surface, BBD does not produce good results. In case of FWD, is there any such limitation? Yes, it is same. Badly cracked, we are not going to do even FWD, similar to BBD. Thank you.
There is one question, name is not there. As per IRC provision of DLC or GSB, thickness is 150 millimeter. Are there chances to reduce this thickness? Actually, DLC is laid over GSB. And function of GSB is separation as well as drainage. From below, water, mud is not allowed to come up, DLC. Another important thing is, see, DLC also, it mix is brought, kept there and compacted by a roller. If you don't have good foundation, good support for DLC, you cannot compact it. On a weak soil, you cannot compact DLC, because DLC is roller compacted, compacted roller. Therefore, you get must strong support should be there for roller to get compacted. It's concrete you can lay, because you by vibration, you normal concrete 50, 60, slope you can lay by vibration. But DLC, roller use and strong foundation necessary so that it can be compacted. So both GHB needed, and both for drainage as well as for separation, minimum 150 millimeter is necessary actually. Concrete block pavement, which I already discussed. Block pavement is a, and you know, cement in the subbase, thickness can be 150 to 200 millimeter because heavy trucks are plying. And your block will not be damaged by water dripping from the sand. Asphalt cannot last. Maybe if you have mastic asphalt, possibly that may last. But these are most appropriate pavement actually. Conservation of VDF as considered for design flexural pavement takes care of the damaging effect of overload only in terms of load up, but how far the permanent distress beyond elastic limit of a layer is being taken care of while designing with IT paved ice cold. Actually, I told you actually this VDF, validity of VDF is how many correct, nobody knows. Because VDF, concept VDF was developed in the 1962 in USA from full scale road test, where load limit was, maximum load was only 30,000 pounds, and there were only few. So extrapolated, it is all extrapolated value. So how about that value? Therefore, we have to develop our methods, axial damage as per the axial load class. What is damage? From 16 to 20 ton axle load, 12 to 16 ton axle load, 10 to 14 ton axle load, like that we have to do a finally evolve a new design method. We have to evolve a new design method, and it will come maybe within the next 10 to 15 years, the new design method is come. So this axle load is the concept within the approximate method, But we have calibrated it after studying about 7 to 8 years. So possibly it may not give any wrong results. While mastic bitumen is not considered as a structural layer, even when it is more than 2 total thick, it is structural layer. It should be considered a structural layer. And it is high emolument, it should be considered a structural layer. In fact, in the proposed identity revision also, it is mentioned is part of structure layer. It is mentioned also. Actually, Mr. Rajiv Chattara himself raised the issue. He should mention, you see, structurally very strong layer, so it's part of structure layer. In a considerable number of roadways, we encounter with thin bitumen layer underneath the base or the sub-base course. In most cases, the bitumen layer is broken or maybe is oxidized. My question is, do we scrap up the layer while placing further? No need to scrap up. But the bitumen layer is absolutely glassy, then you put any WM bitumen slip, like, or WB bitumen slip also. This we have observed in NH6, our existing bitumen layer, the road layer was to be raised directly on that without any furrow and all that. They have put WBF, two-layer WBF, and the traffic loading, heavy traffic loading, it was along the wheel path, slippage was there, so deep depression formed actually. But when the road is asphalt will damage, it can be entry, or maybe it can little scrap, little bit, to make it rough, and then no need of removing them. If we remove, because SMA in place, mastic asphalt, how the SMA will behave in waterlogged area. because we often consider mastic in waterlogged area. SMA is good because binder content is high. It is only slightly less stronger than mastic asphalt, but it's quite strong. In Gujarat, they provide an SMA in a below the underpass, and the whole thing remains somewhat for 7 days, monsoon. But after 7 days, SMA is intact. Nothing happened to SMA. So SMA is quite strong enough. We have to get experience, you know, how it will behave. We have to get experience. As for the fifth premier of Mark, especially some material that can use the surface is reclaimed material from pavement along with other materials. Does it mean that reclaimed bitumen material can also be used as a subgrade, or it is only a non-bitumen material? Yes, reclaimed material can use subgrade, but reclaimed material can't use base quality aggregates. If you add little bit 3% emulsion, it becomes a top class pavement base courses. Why should you waste in subgrade? We should not waste at all in subgrade. You add 3-4% emulsion, you get a material far stronger than the WMM. What is the curing time and procedure for the cementing surface? After how many days laying if traffic can be allowed to fly? Actually, in that case, separation layer need not be there. If there are not fines and with water, fines will not rise. In that case, see, that's why judgment becomes very important. One is type of soil and grades and distribution of separation layer, grade distribution of subgrade soil, they are related actually. The grades of separation layer should be, water separation should be small enough to prevent entry of the subgrade soil or the mud. Brick bags, you know, they crush at the dollar. This is a problem. Brick bags crush around. So if you add some 40% sand in brick bag, if you add sand also, the sand will form and cement. Some fines will form a cushion around the aggregate. And the roller also do not crush. Only crushing limited. Only those aggregates where aggregate contact is there, only they will crush, others will not crush. So definitely the subbase requires lower strength, 2.5 MPa, 2 MPa. It can be used as a subbase material, cementitious subbase material. Mr. Faiz Ahmad, what are the precautionary measures to be taken in constructing rigid pavement in a stretch of road which is inundated every monsoon for a period of at least 1 day, where the inundation is very difficult to avoid? Actually, unless there is a high current, this will not be damaged. We have DLC below, and subgrade, everything is well compacted. This will not be a problem. But if you are losing support because of high current, in that case, you have to take a different measures. You have to take a different measures, actually. Mr. Bajan Sarkar, is there any difference in between rigid pavement and PQC? Actually, rigid pavement is made in PQC only. Pavement quality concrete. Which wearing course is applicable to waste transport district road where moist sand laden trucks run throughout the year with pouring water on the surface? Actually, if all that means there is 365 days in monsoon. Question is, if 365 days is rain, what sort of wearing course we should use? Because sand is coming throughout and water dripping all through. Maybe during monsoon, quarry may be not be there. So only during monsoon, here rain is there. After monsoon, sand is bringing the rain in the form of water dripping from sand. The only thing is, mastic asphalt is the only thing to stand. Or stone mastic asphalt also be able to stand. garage gate, rubber or pre-cast concrete blocks. Brother, rigid pavement can possibly pre-cast concrete block can also stand actually.
I will take the privilege to put my questions now. I have written my questions. Series of questions. First to Professor Kanti Kuna because he has not taken any questions.
The center foot thighs will be separated. And then pour out slowly. And then extract. You have to allow it to evaporate and damage the atmosphere.
Thank you. Thank you then. Now the last part of this program of the workshop, I would like to call upon on the stage our ENC sir and apart from Chief Engineer Headquarter, four most senior Chief Engineers, Mr. Tapan Kumar Shaha, please, towards the professors of IIT who has addressed us, educated us this in this workshop throughout the day. I would like to present the beautiful memento. Please, someone please show. This is the idol of Devi Shwarashati of Dokra. This is the craft of Bengal. Sri Tapan Kumar Shaha, please. Present this to Professor Pandey. Next, Mr. Ujjwal Kumar Mukherjee, please. They will present the memento to Professor M.A. Reddy, please. And Mr. Devashish Roy, Chief Engineer Planning, will present the memento to Professor Kanti Kunapu. Thank you, and the last part is the Thanksgiving ceremony. First, I would like to thank none other than the eminent professors of IIT. They have taken their valued time despite their busy schedule and kindly agreed to accept our invitation, come over from Kharagpur and address us, educated us the whole day. So our thanks and gratitude to them. And as per our wish of our beloved Indian Chief sir, he has told a lot of interest. So he has expressed his willingness that this will continue. And I would like to thank the group of students, the doctoral students. They are so enthusiastic. They are the inspiration behind the professors. A round of applause for the doctoral students. They have accompanied the professors. And next, our additional chief secretary, Sri Indipa Pandey sir. He has instructed, shown the interest, what he has told in the morning in his keynote address, that this workshop was long felt. So thanks to him. Our ENC sir, he has designed all the programs minute to minute. So, round of applause for Indian Chief sir. And applause for them also. And our IT team and the logistic support providers team, they have also done an excellent job. A round of applause for them also.
I forgot to mention a point about the use of bricks. Cemented base, where bricks are weak material, we should not use heavy rollers. Heavy rollers are lower weight, they should be used so that the brick aggregate do not crush. You can have more number passes to get a density.
And
Lastly, probably I have not missed anyone, the press people, the photographers, the videographers, thanks to them also, and the security team also, and the caterer service also. They have probably, you have enjoyed your lunch and tea, snacks. With that, one announcement, I have faced one maximum question. How do we get this materials of the presentation? This is an announcement with the permission of our YNC sir. There's all the presentation will be uploaded in our PWD website. So you'll all be getting these presentations for your reference. With that, this workshop, nice workshop, I think, it comes to an end. Thank you.